Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 16 has been out for almost 2 weeks with the first beta. We're getting close to beta 2, and also 15.6 beta 3 has been out for a few days. We'll talk about that, talk about what you had to say on the YouTube community poll a little bit later in the video, but first I wanted to talk about even more new features that are in iOS 16 that I didn't mention in the initial What's New video and more new features video. The first one has to do with music. If you go into a music playlist, you'll see we have a bunch of different songs here. If I press and hold on those songs, I can copy and drag them, tap other songs, and they stack up, just like you're dragging and dropping an app. You can then go back to maybe a different playlist and drag them into that. So you can go back to your playlist, drag those over here, and it will show you where you can actually drag them into. So that's something that's a little bit new and different. So if we go back in, you'll see that this changes. We can let go and it goes back. So again, copy and paste, scroll through our different songs, and then move them around. So that's something that's all new in iOS 16. Now if we go into Spotlight Search and then run maybe a shortcut, we'll turn the flashlight on, you'll see it runs at the top and then gives us an animation, and then it checks the actual box that it's completed. Hit it again, you'll see it run again, and it actually checks the box after. Prior to this, with iOS 15, that box just sort of showed up with a check mark immediately. Now it's just a little box that circles in and then puts a check there. When you're on the lock screen and maybe you have an alarm set, you'll see here at the top, the little alarm icon looks different than it did before, saying when it will go off next. Then also on the lock screen, when you're using your iPhone as a remote for your Apple TV, looks a little bit different. And you'll see we now have volume buttons instead of a volume slider. When you're on the lock screen or in your notifications, swiping them off the display is slightly different. So if we bring them up here, maybe tap on one, swipe them off the display, they have a different animation to them. So it's a little bit different, looks a little nicer, and it's a little bit more fluid. So if we swipe them off the display, you'll see what it looks like there. When you're in a note and you go to paste or paste anywhere within the system, the paste button actually moves around quite a bit. Muscle memory has me pushing right here to paste, but it usually stays toward the left, or whatever your more prominent actions are will stay toward the left. So that's slightly different, just something I had to relearn. When you go to delete the Find My app, maybe you don't want to use it, tap on Remove App, Delete App. It will actually warn you and say Delete Find My. Deleting this app will not remove any people, devices, or items associated with your Apple ID. Your location may be visible to anyone you are sharing with. You can modify location sharing in settings. So it actually isn't removing the overall sharing of the phone, just the app in order to see it. So that's just something to note that looks new in iOS 16. Now, of course, in Photos, we have this option to copy and paste something out of a photo, which is incredible, but we're waiting for that family shared library. Within the family shared library, thanks to my friend Steve Mosier for pointing this out, within the code, he found that if you're sharing a library with someone and maybe there's an embarrassing photo at a location, you can exclude that or exclude embarrassing photos. There should be an option for that, and maybe we'll see that with beta 2. Now, using iOS 16 over the past couple of weeks has been okay as far as an early beta is concerned. It's much better than previous ones, such as maybe iOS 15 or iOS 13, but it's pretty stable overall. It does have issues, of course, and one thing it took me a little bit to get used to, but I'm starting to really like, is the lock screen. The lock screen font being a little bit different, I really like it, and it's more prominent and easier to read, especially at night if you're using it as an alarm clock. So I really appreciate those things. They seem to be a little bit better, and it's taken time to get used to. I'm not crazy about setting wallpaper and having it switch based on the actual focus modes and things like that, but it's something I'm getting used to and seems to be a really nice addition that you can customize. Now, as far as issues, there are still a few issues where apps crash. The overall weather app is very often not accurate at all. So if we look at iOS 15.6 beta 3, you'll see currently it's very similar, but often I'll find that it takes a lot longer to refresh with iOS 16. So something changed with the weather as far as that goes, and it continues to be inaccurate most of the time. Oftentimes for me, also the mail icon is incorrect as far as how many mail are still unread, and there's just lots of freezes and touch response issues throughout. Oftentimes I'll set a new wallpaper and it will be just sort of a blank background until I change it in our settings and change it overall to a different wallpaper, then it will work. But many times if I go to set a new wallpaper, maybe we'll set a photo, We'll set this photo. Oftentimes it actually is just a blank screen. That time it's working, but oftentimes it doesn't show anything at all and it's just a black screen. So lots of little bugs, of course, that you want to report in the feedback app to help Apple fix if they're not already aware of it. Clearing notifications often doesn't work on the lock screen. So if you go to clear all, many times it just doesn't work. So there's that bug. I continually have that. And also I've had to reboot this about 4 to 5 times. So it's been okay, like I said, but it's an early beta and some of those things are to be expected. Cellular is still just okay, not great, but it seems like something they could improve, of course. And then also it keeps dropping my Wi-Fi password for some reason. So over and over, it will ask me for my Wi-Fi password every couple of days, and that just keeps dropping. That doesn't happen on other versions. Bluetooth is okay. Haven't really had any issues with that, and switching between devices with macOS Ventura. Now, one of the major issues with iOS 16 is battery life. If we go to settings, go to my battery health, you'll see I'm still at 100%, which is pretty good. And over the past few days using it, or past couple weeks, battery life has just been pretty awful. So you'll see last Thursday, I had 3 hours and 57 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 42 minutes of screen off time, and used about 75% of my battery. Typically, when I go to bed at night, I'll have about 50 to 60% of my battery life left. And lately I've had about 20 to 25%. So I'm definitely cycling the battery more. As you can see here with coconut battery, there's more cycles. However, the battery health hasn't dropped yet, but I do expect that soon. The phone also gets very warm all of the time, and many of you report the exact same experience in the comments of the poll. So lots of issues as far as that goes, but again, it's an early beta. I would expect it to get better with beta 2 and beta 3 and the public beta. As far as iOS 15.6 though, battery life on that seems to be quite good. I did a test last night with this iPhone 12 Pro. I plugged it in till 100%, then took it off the charger. I just wirelessly charged it. And you'll see this one, if we go into battery health, go back to battery health, we're still at 100% on this device. And what I did to test this is just leave it off the charger and see what it would do as far as the overall battery. When I picked it up this morning, 7 to 8 hours later, it had 100%. Now it's at 96% since the screen's been on, we're outside. So it's really doing well as far as standby time. And I did have someone send me in their battery life. This one's thanks to Cameron or Connor. And you'll see here, they had 6 hours and 13 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 41 minutes of screen off time. This is on an iPhone 13 Pro Max. So pretty good there, 5 hours and 36 minutes of screen on time, 3 hours and 2 minutes of screen off time. And they used about 50% of their battery. So easily getting over 10 to 12 hours of screen on time with this particular update. So I expect iOS 15 to be much, much better. Battery life on the iPad continues to be what you would expect. At this point, it's just not great. You'll see here as it loads, yesterday I had 1 hour and 49 minutes of screen on time, and the day before that, 3 hours and 26 minutes of screen on time, and used about 65% of my battery. Right now I'm at 57%, and I've recharged it yesterday at 11:49 a.m. So it's doing okay standby time wise, but just in general, it's not great. It's just what you would expect with the iPad lately, but everything else with iPad OS 16 has been pretty good. I haven't had any crashes or issues, just that issue with the weather widget not updating properly. Now, as far as overall performance on older devices, iOS 16 seems to be performing just fine. If we go into the camera, you'll see it's nice and fast. No real issues there other than the apps crashing with banking apps and things like that. But performance wise, it's just fine, whether that be scrolling, going into music, or maybe just loading your favorite game. All of those things seem to be okay. And whether that be an older device or a new device. And as far as the benchmarks, I did run them on the 13 Pro Max, but they don't mean a whole lot this early on. So if we go to Geekbench, you'll see it scored 1,722 for single core, 4,600 for multi-core. If we take a look at the history, you'll see the previous time I ran this was on iOS 15.6 beta 2. So we're actually doing a little bit better than that, but this can vary greatly. And with the phone getting so warm, being outside, it seems like it's ramped down the processor. So last week I had a problem recording this a little bit where the phone got too hot and dropped the display. So it dropped the display brightness down where it's very bright outside. So I keep it full brightness when recording this. So right now there's some issues, like I said, but overall performance is pretty impressive going into different apps and everything else. It seems to load just like you would expect. Now, iOS 15.6 is boring, but it's important. We need stability and bug fixes from iOS 15.5. I've had numerous people mention issues with it, and it's time we have that update until we get iOS 16. There's not a lot of changes, but stability should be the focus, and most report no issues whatsoever with it. So it seems to be a great update, and it should be at this point. Cellular, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and overall stability appear to be much, much better with iOS 15.6. And so that leads me to, should you install iOS 15.6 betas or iOS 16 beta 1? I would say at this point, iOS 15 is fine to install. iOS 16, definitely wait until the public beta. This phone is much warmer than the other one, and it's just been sitting here with the screen on. It's not doing anything. It's a little bit warm outside, but it's not doing anything, and it's really using a lot of power. It's just very buggy from time to time. But again, it's okay for an early beta. So go ahead and install 15.6 betas, but just know that you need a backup. And if you want to go back, you need to use a computer or else you just can't do that. So keep that in mind. As far as when to expect iOS 16 beta 2, well, based on last year, I would expect it maybe Thursday at this point. Last year, Apple released it on Thursday the 24th. Now that's a Friday, but I would expect it probably around Thursday, meaning iOS 15.6 beta 4 or RC would be expected maybe Tuesday or Wednesday, with iOS 16 beta 2 coming out later in the week. As far as iOS 15.5.1, I just don't think there's going to be one at this point. I think Apple's just waiting to iOS 15.6, then they'll push out those bug fixes, security updates, and more, and then they'll continue to work on 15.7. So all of those things should be expected, with the public beta of iOS 16 coming out later in July, according to Apple. So based on what we had last year, we had iOS 15 beta 1 on June 7th, iOS 15 beta 2 on June 24th, which was a Thursday. Then we had a public beta the next week or so, and then iOS 15 beta 3 was on July 14th. That's similar to what I would expect this year, and then we'll move on to similar betas for public and developer releases at the same time. That seems to make the most sense. Now let's go ahead and take a look at some of the comments and what you had to say. Now, at the time of this video, you'll see I made a little typo here where it says I'm using iOS 15.6 beta 1. That should say beta 3. Hopefully most of you recognize that. Then 18% of you are using iOS 16 beta 1. 66% of you are still on public versions. 2% are on 14.8 or earlier, and 8% are using Android. Let's go ahead and see what you had to say. Now let's go ahead and take a look at what you had to say. I have my iPad below, and Lars said on iOS 15.6 beta 3, both iPad Pro 2021 and iPhone 11 Pro Max, both devices very stable and fast, battery seems okay, overall the best iOS 15 so far. And like I said, most people you're going to see similar comments, but with iOS 16, it's a different story. Samuel Felix says, hopefully I'm saying that properly, iOS 16 Dev Beta 1 running on an iPhone 12 Pro Max. Battery is not so great and it gets warm, otherwise smooth. Graham Evans says iOS 15.6 Beta 3 has much better battery life on my iPhone 13. As well, my AirPods connect much faster than Beta 2. They used to take around 10 seconds, but they're now instant with this release. Geekbench scores has improved too. So I think it's really finally much more stable and much better, and I can't wait until all of you get to try out 15.6 if you're still on the public versions. Apple Tech says, I'm on iOS 15.6 Beta 3, came from iOS 15.5 on my 12 Pro Max, and can say battery life and dictation is a lot better. This is probably the best update for iOS 15. It's been very smooth, no lag or issues, and performance has been very good. I'm very happy with this update. Love all your videos, Aaron. Thank you. Edsel Riviera says, iOS 15.6 Beta 3 is a lot better battery life on my iPhone 13 Pro Max. Philip Watts says, I'm running iOS 16 beta on my 12 Pro Max. The performance is good, but the battery life is so bad, can't wait till the next beta to see if it will get better. And like I said, iOS 16 battery is pretty horrendous, usually a few hours and then you'll need to recharge it. Ali Zone says, I'm using iOS 15.6 beta 3 with no issues and perfect battery timing. Network is also better than iOS 15.5. Touch is also smoother than iOS 15.5. Aaron, you're the best. Keep it up. And thank you. DHopper598 says, using beta 3, storage bug is still present using nearly 40 gigabytes of storage from my system data. Tried the syncing tip through Finder on my Mac, did nothing. And so maybe you'll need to use a third-party app, or you could do a fresh reinstall. But if it's not using all the data you need, maybe you're good with storage, maybe you have 512 gigabytes. I would ignore it for now, see if it gets better with the public release. Otherwise, you may want to do a fresh install or possibly try clearing your Safari system cache as well. Heshan Ranmandala said 15.6 beta 3 is much stable on my iPhone 10. No new bugs noticed, and battery life is much better. And so that's everything with iOS 15.6. We're getting very close to the final release of that. I think we'll see a release candidate this coming week, maybe beta 4, but I'm thinking release candidate. And then also, of course, iOS 16 beta 2, and there'll be plenty of other features I'll be finding in that as well. If you've found anything I haven't mentioned, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe, and if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.